Now I played with VGS. So now what I will do, I will make VGS equal to 0. So I have analyzed the condition of JFET when VDS equal to 0 and I have changed the value of VGS. Now ulta. Now make VGS 0 or don't apply anything to gate and source. Now we apply the potential VDS between drain and source. So VDS nali, I told you drain is going to be given positive voltage and source is to be given negative voltage. This is the polarity I'm going to, a battery I'm going to supply. But see here, drain is positive with respect to source. So VDS nale, first whatever terminal come, it is going to be positive. Second, whatever comes, it is going to be negative. So VDS means drain is positive, source is negative. And I am not going to give anything to gate. So VGS equal to 0. You see here, just the terminals are short circuited. Nothing much I am going to disturb in gate. So what happens when you give this... What behavior you expect from this device when you give such arrangement? Can anybody say? This N region is full of electrons and I am giving a positive polarity to drain. So what happens? What happens? How will the device respond to the voltage VDS?
Electron move to drain.
Electron will be moving to drain. Because electrons are negatively charged and drain voltage is positive. So the electrons from the source or from this channel will flow in this direction, correct? They will be moving towards the negative positive polarity of the battery, giving rise to what is called as, if I connect an ammeter here, I can measure the current and that current is called as drain current ID. That current is called as drain current ID. You are able to understand a simple, when you give a positive polarity VDS, when you keep your drain more positive compared to your source, your N region is filled with a lot of electrons. These electrons will move from source towards your drain, giving rise to what is called as a drain current ID. Epome, one thing keep it in your mind, the actual current flowing is opposite to the flow of electrons. So actual current will flow from drain to source. The electronic current will flow from source to drain. Very, 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 very important. Please understand. The current due to electrons will flow from source to drain, but the conventional current, see here the last line, the conventional current will flow from drain to source. See, electron is not our reference. Always we take the current flow, actual current flow is opposite to that of the current flow due to electrons. That is the conventional current flow. Okay, wow. So conventional current will flow from drain to source, but the current due to electron will flow from source to drain. Okay, this is one case, and the current will depend on all these factors. First one is how many electrons are there in the channel. So if you have a lot of electrons, ID will also be, because you know current is rate of flow of electrons, right? So the number current flowing through the channel will depend on, first one, number of majority carriers, how many majority carriers are there inside my channel. Second one, length. So what is the length of my channel? This is the length of my channel. What is the length of my channel? Cross-section area of the channel. So what is the area of a channel at this point? Then what is the VDS voltage I am going to apply? So whenever there is a current flow, there will always be a resistance. So what that resistance, you call it as a channel resistance. So I can say this channel will act like a simple resistance with value R. You know, resistance equal to rho L by A. Rho is the resistivity, L is the length, and A is the area. And you know, by Ohm's law, I is equal to V by R. So ID is equal to what voltage I am applying? I am applying VDS. So ID is equal to VDS by R. So substitute the value of R here. So ID is equal to A into VDS by rho into L. So this is the expression for drain current in terms of channel length, channel area, and applied voltage. And you can see ID is proportional to VDS. So directly proportional. Voltage nariya apply panninga current nariya irukum. And ID is proportional to area. The area is large, more current will flow. And length, you see, ID is proportional to 1 by L. So if the device length is very small, you can get more current. So this is the relation between ID and all the parameters, whatever you are going to apply to the circuit. And rho, you know, the resistivity of the channel. So because of the applied resistance of the channel and VDS, there is a gradual increase of positive potential along the channel from source to drain. So as you know, you are giving drain positive voltage and I'm giving source negative voltage. When electrons slowly move more and more, and electrons are going to move from source to drain in this path, your source will start becoming more and more positive. Because when electrons are leaving, it becomes positive, right? And drain will become more and more negative. So there exists a potential gradient in the channel from source to drain. Okay, there exists a potential gradient in the channel from source to drain. Okay, is that clear? And what happens? Thus, the reverse voltage across the PN junction increases, and hence the thickness of depletion region also increases. So therefore, the channel is wedge-shaped as shown in the figure. So now what happens? This condition is clear drain current. Now I am going to apply both. Any doubt until this case where I am going to give VDS? Any doubt in this case? Any doubt you have, you can ask. I am going to pause for a few minutes. So I hope things are clear. See, here in this case, I have given VGS equal to 0 and I'm increasing VDS. So when I increase the VDS, the current flow is going to happen from source to drain and my drain current is going to be increasing. And now I'm going to apply both the voltage. Now I'm going to simultaneously apply both the voltage, VGS and VDS. That here, you can see here VDS, drain is positive, source is negative, and VGS you see gate is negative and source is positive. Now I am going to apply both the voltage. So when I increase the negative polarity of the gate voltage, my depletion region will be like this wedge shaped. It will be wedge shaped, and I am increasing VDS also. So I am increasing both simultaneously. So in that case, what? Because of this part, see, when VDS was not there, it was a normal depletion region of this size. Just around the P region, you have the depletion region. But since you are applying VDS also here, the depletion region is not looking like a normal depletion. It's looking like a wedge-shaped depletion region. Okay, it is a wedge-shaped depletion region as shown in the figure. Like you can see, the depletion region is extending even beyond the P layer. Okay, it is extending even beyond the P layer. That's why they have given the name. It is going to be a wedge-shaped depletion region. When will a wedge-shaped depletion region occur in a JFET? When you are going to apply both the voltage, VGS and VDS. VGS will be negative and VDS will be positive. Okay, I am still increasing. As the VDS is increased, what will happen? The sectional area of channel will be reduced. And now, because this wedge-shaped region will be reducing your to effective area, right? See, when the depletion region was not formed, the current flow will be maximum. But when the depletion region is slowly occupying the area around your channel, naturally, the area will be reduced. This equation, when area is going to be reduced, the current ID will also be reduced. The drain current will also be reduced. At one particular value, the cross-section area at B becomes minimum. At this voltage, the channel is said to be pinched off, and the drain voltage VP is called pinch-off voltage. Particular voltage, the cross-section area becomes minimum. So minimum means you can say that the wedge shape will be completely occupying the channel, and the area will be minimum. One particular voltage of VDS, that voltage at which you cross section area is called as VP. That VP means it is pinch off voltage. As the result of decreasing cross section area, the following results are obtained. You're able to understand? So, initially we have also seen that it's going to touch. So when the depletion region is going to touch, that condition is called as cutoff. And that value of VGS is going to be called as cutoff voltage VC, correct? One more time, this is going to merge, leading to what is called as reduced channel area. Corresponding value of VDS is called as pinch off voltage VP. Both are for the same purpose only. But when you don't apply any voltage VDS, when you just decrease this gate voltage, what you get is VC. But when you apply both, and when the channel is going to be cut off, and that particular voltage of VDS is going to be called as pinch off voltage VP.